one and all, we have started the lesson number E, that is skeletal system and nervous system. We have learned the concept of skeletal system. In short, I will summarize all the points what we have learned till now. Then we have started with the skeletal system. What is the skeletal system? It is nothing but a framework of the bone which gives the shape and size to our body. Then we have learned the main parts of our skeletal system, that is rib cage, backbone, yes or no? Rib cage, backbone, skull. The skull protect our brain, backbone protect our spinal cord, rib cage protect our heart and lungs, and limbs protect. There are the two types of the limbs, that is hind limb and a forelimb. After that we have learned about the joints. What is meant by the joints? Where the two bones meet together, the bones where they meet together, they are called as a joints. They are joined by a strong tissue that is called as a ligaments. Yes or no? And then we have discussed about the different types of the joints, that is ball and socket joint, gliding joint, hinge joint and pivot joint. Then we have discussed about the, in the last video we have discussed about the muscles. In that we have learned the different types of muscles, that is voluntary, involuntary and cardiac muscle. In today's video we are going to start with the nervous system. But before we start with the nervous system, there are the MCQs which are given in your test book. We will just go through it. Okay, the first MCQ is that bones cannot move without ribs, muscles or bone marrow. Yes, of course, muscles. So take to the muscles, everyone. Then a place where the two bones meet is called as a joints. Yes, so take to the joints. So in today's video we are going to discuss about the nervous system. What is actually the nervous system? Now see, when we are walking, when we are laughing, when we are thinking, this all the other activities are controlled by our one system, that is called as a nervous system. Now see, when we hear any kind of the joke, then immediately we laugh. Yes or no? Why does the action is the reply is given to the joke? Yes or no? So and after sometimes we stop. Yes or no? After laughing we stop our laugh. Why does it happens? Because of our nervous system. This all the activities, walking, when we have to walk, when we have to run, when we have to do cycling, this all the activities are controlled by our system, that is called as a nervous system. Repeating, the system, which system in our body is there which control the activities of walking, running, cycling, whatever the number of activities we do. Yes or no? So these activities are controlled by one of the system, that is nervous system. Nervous systems are mainly classified into three types. That is, the main part of the nervous systems are brain, spinal cord and nerves. Now you know where is the brain is located. We have learned the skeletal system which protect our brain. It is a delicate part. Yes or no? So we have learned in the last video about the skeletal system. The skull protect our brain. It is the main part. Yes or no? Then spinal cord. Yes, where it is located? Can you just tell me? Yes, it is located in the backbone. We have learned about and vertebral column is there. Yes or no? Then this is the next part that we will learn afterwards. So first we will learn about the brain. Now what is the brain? Where is the brain situated? Can you just tell me? Yes, brain is situated at the uppermost part of our body, that is called as a skull. Yes or no? Now brain is mainly classified, or it is divided into the three parts, that is cerebrum, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Which are the main parts of the brain? Cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla oblongata. These are the main part of our brain. Now we will learn them one by one in a detail. The first is cerebrum. Cerebrum, which is the largest part of our brain, is the largest part of our brain. Okay? Cerebrum, it is the largest part of our brain, which helps us to remember. It is also called as a center of intelligence. The cerebrum is also called as a center of intelligence, which helps us to remember the things, which helps us to understand the things, and which helps us to solve the problem. You might be thinking, whenever the thinking or if you want to solve any problem, the main part of our brain which helps us, that is cerebrum. It is the largest part of our brain. Then the next is cerebellum. The next part of our brain is cerebellum. Cerebellum, it is also called as, in Marathi we say chota mendu. In Marathi we say cerebellum as a chota mendu. It is located at the lower part of our, located below the cerebrum. We call it in Marathi as a chota mendu. It is located here. It is located here, which is the smallest part of our brain. Now, what is the function of the cerebellum? It helps us to balance our body. For example, whenever we are walking, whenever we are doing any kind of activity, for example, mostly we are doing the cycling. Now, our age is to do the cycling, am I right? Your age, not mine. It is your age to do the cycling, am I right? Many a times when the speed breaker is there, then you control the speed of your cycle, yes or no? So these all the control, the balance of our control is given by the cerebellum. It is done by the cerebellum. It controls our balance for walking, cycling, running. Then the third main part of our brain is medulla oblongata. It is also called as a brain stem. It is also called as a brain stem. Now, where this is located? It is located below the cerebellum. It is located below the cerebellum. It joins the brain and the spinal cord. It joins the brain and the spinal cord. Now, you know the involuntary actions. Now, what is meant by the involuntary actions? Now, involuntary muscles that we have done in the muscles. Now, can you just tell me what is meant by the involuntary muscles? Now, what is meant by the involuntary muscles? Involuntary muscles are that muscles which are not our control. They are called as a involuntary muscles. Now, medulla oblongata. The function of the medulla oblongata is that involuntary actions takes place here. Involuntary action, for example, the breathing. Now your heart is working day and night. Yes or no? Heart is working day and night. Then you are breathing every time. Yes or no? Even when you are in the sleep, you are breathing. So this all the actions are taken by the medulla oblongata. Are you getting this? That is involuntary muscles. Then the next part of our nervous system is a spinal cord. Which is the next part of our nervous system? That is spinal cord. Now where it is located? It joins our brain and the backbone. It joins our brain and the backbone. The upper part, it is the brain, and the lower end of the, it is up to the lower end of the backbone. Now it protects our vertebral column. It protects our vertebral column. It is nothing but the spinal cord is nothing but it consists of the thick bundles of the nerves. It consists of the thick bundles of the nerves that are connected from our brain to the lower end of our backbone. This is what about the spinal cord. Then the next is nerves. Next are nerves. There are the three types of the nerves, that is sensory, motor, and the mixed. There are three types of nerves: sensory, motor, and mixed. Now, what is the sensory nerve? What are the actually nerves? The nerves are nothing but which carry. Our body has a network of the nerves which helps us to carry the message.
Now, for example, if someone will pinch me, if someone will pinch me, this is my sense organ. Skin is one of the sense organ. If someone will pinch me on my hand, I will immediately remove my hand. Yes or no? What happens is when the message, the nerves send the message that someone is pinching, how will I come to know? The message from the nerves, it is sent to the brain. Now, there are mainly three types of the nerves, sensory, motor and mixed nerve. Sensory nerve sends the message from my hand, means from the sense organ to the brain. Sensory nerves, what is the function of the sensory nerves? It sends the message that someone is pinching me. The sensory organ from my hand is a sense organ, the main part of my body which will carry the message from here that someone is pinching me to my brain, And motor nerves, the next is motor nerve. Now motor nerve, what it will do? It will carry the message that remove your hand. Now if someone is pinching me, then I have to immediately remove my hand. Yes or no? Now this message from my brain to this the part where it is pinched, the message from the brain to my to the sensory organ, the message sent from the brain to the sensory organ to remove my hand, that is done by the motor nerve. The message is sent from brain to the sense organ, that is done by the motor nerve. And mixed nerve, the next third is mixed nerve. The message is sent and it is sent, the order is given by the brain that you have to remove your hand. So that order is given by the brain. So that nerves the message, carry the message and give the order from the brain, that is done by the nerve. So these are the main part of our nervous system, that is brain, spinal cord and nerves. Now what is the main part of our brain is cerebrum, medulla oblongata. Cerebrum is the largest part of our brain. It is also called as a center of intelligence, which helps us to think, which helps us to solve the problems, which helps us to understand the meaning of a particular word. Then next is cerebellum. It is the smallest part of our brain, which controls our brains, which balances our body. And the third part is medulla oblongata, which is situated at the back of the head. The next is spinal cord, which protects our vertebral column. Then the last part of our nervous system is nerves. There are the three types of nerves: sensory, motor and mixed nerve. What is the function of the sensory nerves? It carries the message from the sense organ to the brain. And motor, what is the function of motor nerve? It carries the message from brain to the sense organ. And mixed nerve, the message is carried with the order to the sense organ. Repeating this, I hope you have understood about the nervous system. Now I have given you one example, that is when someone will pinch me, or if you will touch, if you don't know that object is so hot, if the plate is hot and if you will touch it, you will keep touching, you will keep that action going on, or you will immediately remove your hand. Why does it happen? Because of the reflex action. Immediately when the order is given by the brain that you have to remove your hand immediately. Yes or no? So that action is called as a reflex action. The sudden action or the quick response given by the brain. Quick response given by the body and controlled by the spinal cord. So that is called as a reflex action. That is the quick response. Now see, When you are sneezing, automatically your hand comes on your mouth. Yes or no? This action is a quick action. While you are coughing, immediately your hand comes near the mouth. Yes or no? So why does it happen? This is a quick response which is given by the body part to the spinal cord. Are you getting? And controlled by the spinal cord. So there are some quick actions which has to be respond immediately. So that is called as a reflex action. This part we are going to learn about the sense organ. But before that, there are the two MCQs. We will go through it. What are the nerves that carries the message from the brain to the different part of our body? From the brain to the different part of the body. So which is that? Motor nerve. So think to the motor nerve. Which is the largest part of our brain? Cerebrum. So tick to the cerebrum. Okay. So today's work is that you have to read this lesson, nervous system, and remove the difficult words and write in your science notebook. Thank you.